Welcome to the BioBalance Healthcast, episode number 438, The Myths of Testosterone Pellet Insertions.
BioBalance Healthcast features conversations about positive aging. Your hosts are Dr. Kathy Maupin, Medical Director of BioBalance Health and a leading expert in treating symptoms of aging, and Brett Newcomb, a licensed professional counselor. Dr. Maupin and Brett are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about hormone replacement therapy for women, which is available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients.
So we are going to be talking this week about what people hear in mainstream media, talking to their doctors, just in the ethos of the atmosphere. When they come to the office as first-time patients, they often express concerns that they have heard about, well, if I get this done, will this happen to me or will that happen to me? And there are a dozen or so myths that are somewhat prevalent that we would like to address today.
And dispel,
absolutely. So let's go through the list that we have and talk about those. The first one being depression. Does getting testosterone pellets cause depression? Or worsen it?
No, and that's a big no.
Yeah.
In general, testosterone is a mood elevator. It's the opposite of what people think. They think, I'm going to be depressed if I get testosterone. Well, it doesn't do that. It makes you happy. And it doesn't make you aggressive. It makes you calm. It's a really interesting myth that people have just developed saying, oh, you get testosterone, you're going to get depressed. That's truly...
And based on your experience, not that it causes depression, but if someone's already depressed, do you notice any alleviation just from the effect of the testosterone in their depression?
If someone has had depression their whole life, they've inherited a low level of serotonin or a low level of epinephrine and dopamine in their brains, then testosterone may slightly improve their depression. Mm-hmm. But if your depression started when your testosterone dropped, when you were 35, 38, if you're female, and 45, 50, if you're male, if that's when your depression began and you start taking antidepressants, then that's usually the cause, low testosterone. And so when we treat it, it goes away.
Okay. So one thing to think about is whether or not it's a new condition in your life, especially as you begin to age, you start to have these issues.
Which means that it's related to the drop in testosterone. So when we treat it with replacing what caused it in the beginning, which is low testosterone, then we fix it.
So as a therapist, I've worked with a lot of people that were depressed. I've also worked with a lot of people that suffered from anxiety attacks, and acute anxiety in particular. Mm-hmm. We often say that they're comorbid, that they'll come in as a presenting problem, either side of it. You deal with that, and the other side emerges. And so
they have both.
Yeah. So what would we say about testosterone pellets and the impact or the causative factor for anxiety?
Well, testosterone is a calming hormone, and the pellets act just like when you got your testosterone, when you had testosterone when you were younger. Mm-hmm. So because we can replicate that, it brings us back to calming and less anxious. Okay. Now, when people come to us, oftentimes they complain of anxiety. They've developed anxiety partially because they lack the testosterone that stimulates the anti-anxiety neurotransmitters, but also because when FSH and LH, the two hormones that go up from your pituitary gland that used to stimulate the ovaries and the testicles, when they go up, they create anxiety in the brain. So that means low testosterone, high FSH-LH, that makes anxiety. Testosterone fixes it.
I remember years ago I had a couple that I was seeing that was also working with you. Mm-hmm. And the female of the couple was experiencing both depression and anxiety. It kind of flopped back and forth. When she came to see you and got pellets inserted, I got a panic call maybe 3 days later because she was anxious about the fact that her sex drive had been rejuvenated. She had not had one for years. And she was feeling arousal and desire, awareness of sexually intense feelings in ways she had not experienced forever. And she called me to say, am I going to be responsible enough? Am I going to be able to resist this so that I don't jump on the mailman or the the delivery boy? And I laughed.
I remember this.
It's amusing unless it's happening to you.
Right, and we explain this ahead of time. We try to explain that there are some
noticeable side effects
yeah. that cause hypersexuality for a short period of time, and then it goes away. When your body gets used to the testosterone being back in your system,
right.
then the hypersexuality calms down. It's usually a couple of weeks.
Your receptor sites are starved, and as a result of that starvation, you don't feel sexual desire.
At all.
But as they begin to saturate, you get a flush of sexual desire. Mm-hmm. When they stabilize, then you get the normal rhythms of sexual desire.
Right, and so we have to ask patients to be patient and wait it out, or keep your head down. You know, when you go to Sam's, you know, walk around looking at the floor for a couple of weeks because, you know, every guy 8 to 80 is at risk.
Yeah,
but that's
don't go trade your old husband in on a new model just in the first
in
couple
the first
of weeks.
Couple
wait
of
a while,
weeks.
Yeah.
But it is anxiety over a real condition.
Yes.
So yes, you can get anxiety over
a real thing,
as
opposed to having just generalized anxiety disorder.
Right, which means you're anxious about everything. Now, some people get anxiety. When we put the pellets in, they can get anxiety from the medication we use. We use lidocaine with epinephrine so they don't bruise or they don't bleed. So when we put that in, there's a short period of time, which is like less than an hour, where they feel anxious. Some people do and most people don't.
Yeah, I don't.
And I don't.
I have that happen.
I've never had that.
Yeah.
Feeling, but some people
do.
Some
people are just more
it.
Sensitive, and I, my own bias is that women are more sensitive because they are more aware of their bodies than
right.
men are
I
trained
agree
to
with
be.
That.
And so they may feel some of these things that men don't feel.
Although I'll say that the next generation of men
are going to be more
the men
sensitive.
That are turning. Well, they are actually the ones that are turning 50 now are you know are in their 40s. Are more sensitive than the guys that are 60 and 70. Sorry, you're sensitive, but not every guy your age
That's
right.
is. I am.
But I mean, I don't want to put everybody into that group.
No. But again, talking about the myths about that surround the whole thing about getting pellets, testosterone and estrogen pellets, is that you'll have these side effects.
Well, I have had some people get anxious because we just put pellets in them and they can't take them out.
Right.
They want to
change their mind.
They want to be in control. So on the way home, we got one call that sticks in my mind. The patient was on the way home. She was driving and she called us and said that she was having an anxiety attack from the testosterone. Well, testosterone doesn't get into the system that fast from getting pellets. It generally takes 2 weeks on the first dose for you to get any kind of appreciable feeling from the testosterone.
Mm-hmm.
So her anxiety, after we discussed it, was more about, I have something inside my hip and I can't take it out.
Right.
That had nothing to do with testosterone. It was her own fears coming forward. And that's real. And yes, we have to just calm people down
right.
that have that feeling of I'm not in control.
Yeah.
But once they get the pellets and they feel better, that doesn't seem to be an issue at all.
Mm-hmm.
But at first, they've got this new thing, and I can't change it feeling.
Yeah, actually, that's one of the talk therapy treatments for depression or anxiety is to work with people on calming them down, teaching them to breathe and slow down their process. And for this patient, that would be something that I would recommend. Just
that makes me think of what my daughter
and,
used to always say to me.
What?
Like, she's a teenager. Breathe, Mom.
Just
breathe, Mom. Breathe. Yeah. You know, when they're, you know.
She's more than 10 now, and she still says that to you.
So. I know she does.
So another myth around the whole issue of testosterone is what I read about in mass media about hypermasculinity, and that if I get testosterone, then my anger that men are identified as being more likely to have and more likely to be out of control with is going to get worse. And so if I get testosterone pellets, am I going to experience, or the people around me going to experience me as being more angry than I normally am? Am I going to get reactive with a rage attack, like road rage or something?
Mm-hmm.
Am I at risk for that if I get testosterone pellets?
So testosterone does not cause rage. That's not what causes rage.
Mm-hmm.
Rage causes rage. People just have, you know, developing rages and as a response to frustration in their lives or just things not going their way. But two things. So testosterone is not the cause, but I have had some people that believe that myth so much that they felt they were becoming more angry. And it's like two of them out of 100,000 visits we've had at our
patient
office.
Patient visits, right.
Patient visits. Two patients have had that I know of. And I don't believe that it's more
related
than that.
To the testosterone.
And I really believe that was a self-fulfilled prophecy. They believed it would happen, and so it did. And so you can't have that preconceived. That's what we're trying to do today is have you relax about this. This isn't going to happen because of pellets.
Yeah.
This isn't the problem.
Well, as you said, in therapy, I teach people all the time that anger is original issue equipment. You cannot not be angry. Mm-hmm. But there are levels of anger that you need to learn to feel and express, get out. Rage is way up the list of levels, and you can avoid that whole rage thing if you learn how to be angry at cheaper levels, at smaller levels.
But if people don't ever learn to be angry,
then they have two schedules, on and off. You know, it's like, I'm not angry, I'm rageful.
And sometimes when some men come to me, they're so tired, they're so depressed because they have no testosterone, they're deflated, basically, and they look deflated. And when they get back to their normal person, I've had one call from a wife that said, my husband's angry and he's yelling at us and he's doing this and he's doing that. And I said, so this is 3 weeks later, so now his testosterone's where it used to be when he was young. So did he do this when he was young? And she said, yep. And we were so glad it was over. So he had been so
depressed.
So you
take those pellets out.
Yeah, he had been so depressed that he no longer had the energy to be angry.
Yeah.
I'm sure he was angry inside.
Yeah.
But he didn't express it. So we talked to him, lowered the dose, got him into counseling, you know, that kind of thing, so that he could learn how to deal with his anger.
This is one of the things that we talk about in both of our books, that if you have been without your hormones for a significant period of time, you make adaptations and accommodations for the way that you deal with things sexually, the way that you deal with things emotionally. If you get your hormones back, then you're going to have to learn adjustments to the adjustments that you've learned to make. And so part of that is communication, part of that is self-awareness, part of that is self-discipline.
You have to think back, what was I like when I was 30?
Well, but you help, not only that, but you help people think back to what was I like before I started getting pellets. Because mm-hmm. you track all the symptoms that they present with for however long they come to you.
So this is a method that we use in the office, because once patients feel better from testosterone, about a year down the line, they go, I don't need this. I feel great.
Yeah.
Well, the only reason they feel great is because they have testosterone, and it's now in a nice, even level. They keep getting it at the normal 4 or 6 month repetition, and they feel like themselves. But that doesn't mean they're going to feel like themselves without it.
Well, because if you go off of it, you regress back to whatever you felt before. And so a number of them will come in rather sheepishly and say, I shouldn't have stopped.
Oh, they
Others
all do
Others will
that.
Come in rather aggressively and say, why didn't you tell me?
Well, we do tell them, but they don't remember.
They don't want to hear it,
But we go through each symptom and go, well, are you tired anymore? No. Do you have arthritis anymore? No. Do you know, and every single symptom, they go, no. And then, but you had these. No, I didn't. And then we have to show them that they filled out the form with those symptoms.
I remember when I first started coming to you to get pellets, when I would get up in the morning, it would take me 4 or 5 steps to unfold and straighten up. Mm-hmm. And my wife as well. I mean, mm-hmm. she was having
and
the same concerns.
She's much younger than you.
She's a lot younger than I am. But I remember she came back to bed in the middle of the night one night, and she punched me and she said, did you see that? I was sound asleep. And I'm like, did I see what?
Like,
you know, well, sometimes she's done that and said, there's a spider, you know, you do it. But this time she said, I just got up and went to the bathroom. And I'm like, yeah.
She
said, I just got up. You know, I didn't unfold. I didn't have. And
I
then,
didn't
and then
stumble
I
around.
Realized that I was doing the same thing. And I'm still doing the same thing. So
we remember remember things as we feel them, but emotions and symptoms are often forgotten when they're gone.
Okay, well, there's something I've never felt and do not remember, but I've heard that testosterone pellets cause it, and that's UTIs.
Okay, urinary tract infections are something that women usually have a lot more experience with than men, and when we're young and we're having a lot of sex, We have a lot more urinary tract infections because we have anatomically, we have a short urethra and it's right next to the vagina and the rectum. And so bacteria get into the bladder with sex. That's just what happens. So we learned things when we were younger to urinate before and after sex and to take vitamin C to acidify the urine so it didn't allow the bacteria to grow. We forgot that. When we get our pellets back and we start having regular sex.
So girls get taught that stuff? Because guys don't.
Well, guys don't have urinary tract infections.
Well, okay.
I mean, in general, you don't have them unless your prostate's blocking the blocking your bladder. So that's why you're not.
So I probably don't have vaginal infections either.
No.
And that's another one of the myths.
And these were originally kind of aimed at women. But vaginal infections, here's what happens. People go to their doctor and they say, I just got testosterone pellets and now my vagina and my vulva, they don't say it like that, they have a different name for it, are itching all the time and I'm scratching it and I think I have an infection. There's something going on there. And the doctors don't really get that they've been years without testosterone. Mm-hmm. And what testosterone does is bring blood flow back to the vagina. So after years of no testosterone, the vagina shrinks, the labia flatten out, your whole bottom as a female looks different and looks old and looks like it doesn't have any blood, like it's dying.
Well, in your first book, The Secret Female Hormone, you call it old lady bottom. You describe that phenomenon.
Right. Yeah, it is old lady bottom.
Yeah.
But when you get your testosterone back, in the very first month or so, after you start feeling it, all of a sudden, blood flow is going back to your pelvis and your clitoris is visible and your labia are getting
And you make
engorged.
More lubrication.
And there's more lubrication. So people look at that and go, oh, infection, because they haven't had it in so many years. They've
forgotten what it is.
And it's an over response, kind of like what we talked about at the very
libido.
Beginning.
Yeah.
The libido is one of those things, just like the vagina and the swelling that comes with a new onset of testosterone. It never happens again. It doesn't happen with each pellet insertion. It just happens the first time.
As all of the tissues reload to their base level.
And the longer you've been without testosterone or the longer it's been since menopause, the more you get that overreaction.
Right. Okay.
So.
Other myths that we hear about, abdominal bloating and constipation. Can you speak to those?
Yes. So with our pellets, we don't tend to get abdominal bloating and constipation.
All right, let's talk about that. We order pellets from two different pharmacies. They're compounding pharmacies. They make them to your order.
Right.
And they are not micronized.
They are.
A lot of the larger compounding pharmacies that make them.
To make them cheaper.
To mass produce them and make them cheaper. Micronize them. So
we use pure powder testosterone, and it is uniform. Every pellet is uniform. It dissolves in the same way every single time. It has the same dose. We've sent them for evaluation, and we stopped doing it after a while because it was always right.
Always the same, yeah.
And our patients were always happy with it in the same way. We could use the same dose and get the same blood level. But our pellets bring you back to health. And if you get the cheaper kind, which you won't know unless your doctor looks into it, he may not know or she may not know. Micronized means they're all in little balls instead of a powder. They've made these into little balls, and they do that for sublingual tablets to make it last longer. And they do it for vaginal tablets to make it last longer in the body. But what happens with pellets is, it goes through the body and it can't get out. It keeps going through the liver and it makes more and more DHT, dihydrotestosterone.
Mm-hmm.
And it also makes more estrone. So people get big bellies, they get belly fat, they get swollen. And the constipation is something that is really not seen with our pellets, but other pellets, and I don't know what the mechanism is for that, but that is something people complain about.
So what you're essentially saying, if I'm hearing you accurately, is that these are not just myths. They do happen, but they don't happen at your office because of the pellets that you buy.
Right. And if I look at it a different way, if somebody comes in and says, I'm bloating, they usually were bloating before the pellet. If they're with our pellets, If they have bloating, generally that means one of two things. Their thyroid's low, or they have too many carbs in their diet and they're retaining water. That one gram of carb makes you sequester a cc of water. So the more carbs, more water. So you get swollen.
And so is that why you get bloated drinking beer?
That's one of the reasons.
Okay.
But alcohol also shuts your liver down from processing anything else because it's trying to get the alcohol out. It's a poison.
Okay.
I drink alcohol, but very little because of that.
Well, moderation in all things.
Right. So that's...
So a couple more real quickly. Mm-hmm. Blood clots and migraine headaches.
So we've had lots of people think that testosterone is going to cause blood clots. But first of all, non-oral estrogen doesn't cause blood clots. They've already proven that, and many doctors don't know that. So if you take estrogen with a pellet or a patch, that doesn't cause blood clots.
But the pellets are put in your fat tissue, fat cells, not in your blood.
It's absorbed by your blood.
Right, but it isn't directly inserted in the blood.
No.
Like a shot could be. I mean, when you go get blood tests or something, mm-hmm. they put a needle in your vein. So it's just in the tissues, and it's caught up like anything else that gets caught up in your body.
It's absorbed, but if you take estrogen orally, it goes through your liver and makes clotting factors, increases clotting. If you take testosterone orally, it can do the same thing. But oral is quite a big leap from oral to pellets. Pellets are quite different, and they are more like what you made before. People don't get blood clots when they're young and healthy.
So some of the myths about testosterone are really relevant to other methods of delivery than you use
in your office. That's right. And there's so many.
So they may still be somewhat more legitimate, but because of the type you take.
With a different kind of testosterone, right. With an oral type of testosterone. But because of pellets and because of it being pure testosterone, at least in our hands, we don't get these side effects because they're not due to testosterone. They're just myths. Some people can work themselves up into believing it.
Right.
Or it can be from something else that happens. Maybe they have low thyroid and they get treated with the wrong thyroid, or somebody takes them off what we put them on.
Yeah, so we always talk about the placebo effect, and placebo effects can be positive or negative. If you go into a situation anticipating negative outcomes and looking for them, you're more likely to find them. And if you go in anticipating positive outcomes and looking for them, you're more likely to find them. What we want you to know, though, is that there are myths out in the community about the whole process of getting testosterone replacement. We would encourage you to educate yourself about the differences in the delivery systems and that pellets are the safest and most consistently reliable, and that the side effects that we've identified today are not identified with pellets. And you can approach that conversation with your doctor with more confidence if you ask the questions that you have. If you are aware of these myths, ask them about them, and they better be able to give you a good answer.
And the pellets will probably work better for you because you already know you're not looking to these things as problems in the future.
Right.
You're not worrying about that. You're actually looking for your symptom resolution.
And you'll get it.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@biobalancehealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit biobalancehealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at facebook.com/biobalancehealth. Find Brett Newcomb at brettnewcomb.com.